Good morning, everyone, and welcome to today's webinar. This is Joanna Mbarak, and I'm the head of Potec Labs and Potec Academy. Today's webinar is about artificial intelligence in cybersecurity. You can enter your questions and comment in the chat box throughout the presentation. We will have a Q&A session at the end to answer them. We'll be sending you after the webinar a link to the presentation recording. So now we can begin. Let's get started. The outlines. This presentation will first define artificial intelligence, machine learning, and deep learning, and look at their area of application. Next, I'll introduce the elements that make up computer vision, natural language processing, speech, robotics, and general machine learning structured and unstructured data. Then we will understand various AI techniques and move to list some important threats coming with this technology. The next section will discuss how ML became a vital technology for cybersecurity. At the end, we will turn to POCs. We can trace the history of artificial intelligence back to the 1950s, when a generation of scientists, mathematicians, and philosophers started discussing the concept of an intelligent machine. From 1957 to 1974, research in AI flourished thanks to development in computer and reduced cost. Today, the technology is present in our daily lives, bringing with it some transformative advantages, but also some important threats. AI covers a wide branch of computer science concerned with designing smart machines capable of performing tasks that require human intelligence. These machines can be trained to accomplish objectives that require human interaction by processing a huge amount of data. And since computers are well known for their incredible processing speed, artificial intelligence took a huge success. Machine learning is an application of AI. It is the process of teaching a system to accomplish a specific task by processing a very huge amount of data and predicting the correct answers and improving from experience. Deep learning is a subset of machine learning in which layered neural networks combined with high computing power and large data sets can create powerful machine learning models. Neural networks are inspired by our understanding of the biology of our brains, all those interconnections between the neurons. But unlike a biological brain where any neuron can connect to any other neuron within a certain physical distance, these artificial neural networks have discrete layers, connections, and direction of data propagation. Artificial intelligence has various applications in today's society. It is becoming essentially for today's time because it can solve complex problems with an efficient way in multiple industries, such as healthcare, entertainment, finance, education. AI is making our daily life more comfortable and fast. AI can automate grading so that the tutor can have more time to teach. AI chatbot can communicate with students as a teaching assistant. AI in the future can work as a personal virtual tutor for students, which will be accessible easily at any time and any place. AI in finance. The finance industry is implementing automation, chatbot, adaptive intelligence, algorithm trading, and machine learning into financial processes. AI in data security. The security of data is crucial for every company, and cyber attacks are growing very rapidly in the digital world. AI can be used to make your data more safe and secure. AI in robotics. Artificial intelligence has a remarkable role in robotics. Usually, general robots are programmed such that they can perform some repetitive tasks, but with the help of AI, we can create intelligent robots which can perform tasks with their own experiences without being pre-programmed. Humanoid robots are best example for AI in robotics. Recently, the intelligent humanoid robot named as Erika and Sophia has been developed which can talk and behave like humans. AI in healthcare. In the last 5 to 10 years, AI becoming more advantageous for the healthcare industry and going to have a significant impact on the industry. AI can help doctors with diagnosis and can inform when patients are worsening so that medical help can reach to the patient before hospitalization. In astronomy, artificial intelligence can be very useful to solve complex universe problems. AI technology can be helpful for understanding the universe, such as how it works, its origin, etc. Agriculture is an area which requires various resources, labor, money, and time for best result. Nowadays, agriculture is becoming digital, and AI is emerging in this field. Agriculture is applying AI as agriculture robotics, soil and crop monitoring, predictive analysis. AI is becoming highly demanding for travel industries as well. AI is capable of doing various travel-related work, such as from making travel arrangements to suggesting the hotels, flights, and best route to the customers. In entertainment, we are currently using some AI-based application in our daily life with some entertainment services such as Netflix or Amazon. With the help of machine learning or AI algorithm, these services show the recommendation for programs or shows. AI can be used for gaming purposes as well. The AI machines can play strategic game like chess, where the machine needs to think of a large number of possible places. AI in social media. Social media sites such as Facebook, Twitter, and Snapchat contains billions of user profiles, which need to be stored and managed in a very efficient way. AI can organize and manage massive amounts of data. AI can analyze lots of data to identify the latest trend, hashtag, and requirement of different users. AI is becoming a competitive edge to the e-commerce industry, and it is becoming more demanding in the e-commerce business. AI is helping shoppers to discover associated products with recommended size, color, or even brand. The different fields of AI. Computer vision. When it comes to images, artificial intelligence has existed under different names since the 60s. Computer vision and image recognition. But what exactly is computer vision? Computer vision is the art and science of making computers understand images. The field of computer vision is too expensive to cover in depth. The technique of computer vision can help a computer to extract, analyze, and understand useful information from a single or a sequence of images. There are many advanced techniques like style transfer, colorization, action recognition, 3D object, human pose estimation. The commonly used technique for computer vision include image classification. It refers to a process in computer vision that can classify an image according to its visual content. Object detection. Algorithms produce a list of object category present in the image along with an axis-aligned bounding box indicating the position and scale of every instance of each object category. Image segmentation goes one step further than object detection. For each pixel, the most automatically element of information in an image, we identify to which object it belongs to. This one of the reason why use cases in healthcare, particularly in cancer detection, are becoming more and more widespread. Object tracking means estimating the state of the target object present in the scene from previous information. There are mainly two levels of object tracking, single object tracking and multiple object tracking. NLP. Natural Language Processing, or NLP, is an automatic computational processing of human languages. It's a computer science area of research that explores how computers can be used to understand and manipulate human language, text, or speech. Speech recognition, natural language processing, understanding, and the intelligent assistant Siri all derive from NLP. Text classification, also called text tagging or text categorization, is the process of assigning text into organized groups. Using NLP, text can be automatically analyzed, then assigned to a group of predefined categories depending on its content. Name entity recognition is the task of identifying and categorizing key information in a text. Information retrieval is a software program that deals with the organization, storage, retrieval, and evaluation of information from document repositories. Machine translation is the task of automatically converting one natural language into another. Many of the tools that make our lives easier today are possible thanks to NLP. Natural language processing tools are important for businesses that deal with large amounts of unstructured text, whether emails, social media conversation, online chats, survey responses, and many other forms of data. AI speech. Speech recognition is a process that enables a computer to recognize and respond to spoken words and then converting them in a format that the machine understands. The machine may then convert it into another form of data depending on the end goal. Speech recognition technology uses natural language processing to transform spoken language into a machine-readable format. Speech recognition systems are an essential part of virtual assistants like Siri, Alexa, and Google Assistant, for example. However, there are more and more use cases of speech recognition in business. For example, adding speech-to-text capabilities to business software, companies are able to automatically transcribe call, send email, and even translate. A trigger word is a word that you use to wake up a virtual voice assistant. Speaker ID is a voice biometric technology that allows to accurately verify and identify speakers by their unique voice characteristic. Speech synthesis is simply a form of output where a computer or other machine reads words to you out loud in a real or simulated voice played through a loudspeaker. The technology is often called text-to-speech, TTS. Robotics. The branch of engineering or the technology focusing on constructing and operating robots is called robotics. Most robots use some form of AI. Robots that are not AI-enabled would perform a set of tasks with little or no decision-making. In robotics, perception is understood as a system that grants the robot to the ability to perceive, comprehend, and reason about the surrounding environment. Other notion we have motion planning, also control systems. General machine learning. So data structures refer to specific ways of storing and organizing data. Different data structures possess different relationships between data points, but data can also be unstructured. Unstructured data is data that isn't organized in a predefined fashion or lacks a specific data model. Meanwhile, structured data is data that has clear, definable relationship between the data point with a predefined model containing it. Structured data is often held in DBMS such as Excel file or SQL databases. In contrast, the way unstructured data is stored is typically with a NoSQL database. The vast majority of data is in unstructured formats. In terms of machine learning, certain techniques can help order unstructured data and turn it into structured data. The second section will illustrate AI techniques, namely supervised and unsupervised learning, transfer learning, reinforcement learning, GANs, and finally knowledge graph. Machine learning algorithms are grouped into four major classes, which correspond to different types of learning. Supervised learning, the algorithm is given a certain number of examples or input to learn from. And these examples are labeled, that is, we associate them with a desired result or output. The algorithm then has for task to find the law which make it possible to find the output according to the inputs. Unsupervised learning, no label is provided to the algorithm and that it discovers without human assistance the characteristic structure of the input. The algorithm will build its own representation. Transfer learning, it's a learning that can come to optimize and improve a learning model already in place. Reinforcement learning, it is an intermediary between the first two algorithms. This technique does not rely on the evaluation of labeled data, but operates according to an experience reward method. The process is evaluated and re-injected into the learning algorithm to improve decision rules and find a better way out of the problem. Machine learning algorithm. So we can use the classification algorithm for predicting a set of items, class or category. Some of the classification algorithm include k-nearest neighbors, decision trees, random forest, support vector machine, naive bias. We use regression algorithm for predicting continuous values like linear regression, polynomial regression, exponential regression. We have also logistic regression and logarithmic regression. We use clustering algorithm for summarizing or to structure data. We use association algorithm for associating co-occurring items or event. We use dimensionality reduction for reducing the size of data to extract only useful features from a data set. We use sequential pattern mining for predicting the next data events between data example in a sequence. We use anomaly detection for discovering abnormal activities and unusual cases. We have also recommendation system. We use recommender algorithm to build recommendation engines. We have also GANs. GAN or generative adversarial network. So a GAN is a deep neural network framework which is able to learn from a set of training data and generate new data with the same characteristic as the training data. For example, a GAN trained on photograph of human faces can generate realistic looking faces which are entirely fictitious. GAN has two parts. The generator learns to generate plausible data. The generated instance became a negative training example for the discriminator. And the discriminator learned to distinguish the generator's fake data from real data. The discriminator penalizes the generator for producing implausible results. So when training begins, the generator produces obviously fake data. And the discriminator quickly learned to tell that it's fake. Knowledge graph. The power we have in Google search engine at the original page rank algorithm is based on a form of a knowledge graph. So in fact, a knowledge graph is a database which store information in a graphical format and can be used to generate a graphical representation of the relationship between any of its data points. Facebook also relies on this form of information organization to keep track of networks of people and the connection between them. Netflix uses knowledge graph technology to organize information on its vast catalog of content, drawing connection between movies and TV shows and the actors, directors, or producers who put them together. In supply chain logistics, knowledge graph can be used to keep track of inventories of different components and parts, allowing manufacturers to understand the crossover between materials that are used in different products. As we have seen, AI can bring an array of benefits and improve our daily life, but it can also bring some important threats. This section will illustrate some of them. AI programmed to do something dangerous, as in the case with autonomous weapons programmed to kill, is one way AI can pose risks. Social manipulation. Social media, through its autonomous powered algorithm, is very effective at targeting marketing. They know who we are, what we like, and are incredibly good at summarizing what we think. By spreading propaganda to individuals identified through algorithm and personal data, AI can target them and spread whatever information they like in whatever format they will find most convincing. Invasion of privacy and social grading. It is now possible to track and analyze an individual's every move online, as well as when they are going about their daily business. Cameras are nearly everywhere, and facial recognition algorithms know who you are. Misalignment between our goals and the machines. Part of what humans value in AI-powered machine is their efficiency and effectiveness. But if you aren't clear with the goals we set for AI machine, it could be dangerous if a machine isn't armed with the same goals we have. For example, a command to get me to the airport as quickly as possible might have dire consequences, without specifying that the rules of the road must be respected because we value human life. A machine could quite effectively accomplish its goal of getting you to the airport as quickly as possible and do literally what you asked, but leave behind a trail of accidents. Discrimination. Since machines can collect, track, and analyze so much about you, it's very possible for those machines to use that information against you. It's not hard to imagine an insurance company telling you you're not insurable based on the number of times you're caught on camera talking on your phone. For example, another example, an employer might withhold a job offer based on your social credit score. AI phenomenon, deepfakes. So what are deepfakes? The word deepfake combines the term deep learning and fake, and is a form of artificial intelligence. Deepfakes are falsified audio or videos made by means of deep learning. So deepfakes refer to manipulated videos or other digital representation produced by sophisticated artificial intelligence that shield fabricated images and sound that appear to be real. So it is to film what Photoshop is to images. The danger of that is the technology can be used to make people believe something is real when it is not. Earlier this year, we've organized a webinar dedicated to deepfakes. You can check the recording, which is available on YouTube, and subscribe to Potek's YouTube channel as well. AI man. The concept of an augmented soldier consists of using various technologies to increase the physical and cognitive capacities of the opponent. Suppose all of our soldiers become bionic men who run fast, don't need to sleep, eat, and drink very little, and can fight all the time. But will this allow us to face an enemy when we no longer have the political will? Worse, does this not risking contributing to an extremely serious ethical distancing from the adversary and therefore to a creeping dehumanization of our augmented soldier? These will come closer and closer to the transhumanist fantasy of individuals at the frontier of immortality, whose emotion can be programmed in the name of their optimization. From the augmented soldier serving the Western good to the humanoid robot projected onto the battlefield acting for the best according to the criteria of computer programming, there is only one step. AI and cybersecurity. So AI has become a vital technology for cybersecurity. AI can preventively stamp out cyber threats and bolster security infrastructure through pattern detection, real-time cybercrime mapping, and through penetration testing. However, AI can have profound security implications for cybersecurity. Therefore, secure and resilient techniques and best practices are vitally important. Recent advances in AI are transformative and already exceed human-level performance in tasks like image recognition, natural language processing, and data analytics. However, AI systems can be manipulated, evaded, and misled, resulting in profound security implications for applications. There is a pressing need for formal method to verify AI and machine learning components. As AI systems are deployed in high-value environment, the issue of ensuring that the decision process is trustworthy, particularly in adversarial scenario, is paramount. AI is often vulnerable to corrupt input that produce inaccurate responses from the learning, reasoning, or planning system. Efforts are needed to harden learning methods against adversarial input. Research needed to develop theory, engineering principle, and best practices when using AI as a component of a system, including threat modeling, security tools, domain vulnerability, and securing human-machine teaming. So just as the AI system needs innovative cybersecurity tools and methods to improve their trustworthiness and resiliency, cybersecurity can use AI to increase awareness, react in real time, and improve its overall effectiveness. This includes self-adaptation and adjustment in the face of ongoing attacks that alter the current attackers versus defender asymmetries. AI technologies can capture and process the enormous amount of data produced by today's technology systems. In turn, the ability to provide the training data needed to drive AI system innovation and development. AI-based reasoning aligned with cybersecurity priorities could make both fully automated and human-in-the-loop system more trustworthy. Promising research involves leveraging AI to detect error in program, check best practices, identify security vulnerabilities, and making it easier to design security into system. Both autonomous and semi-autonomous systems will need to plan for worst case and anticipate, respond, and analyze potential and actual threat occurrence. The ability to intervene before a network is shut down requires a top-down strategic approach. As ML and AI systems improve the performance of individual cybersecurity tools, coordination and orchestration between multiple tools become increasingly important. Successful execution may require that models include interaction with other systems. These systems may involve different goals and objectives, cybersecurity tools, and intent and state of mind of human actors. Coordination and trust between human AI interfaces is critical. The right level of trust requires that human can identify a system state and predict behavior under various circumstances. There has been significant research into game theory models that can be used to understand attack plans and reason about potential defenses. But because an adversary's actions are still not easily observable and information is not perfect, more research is needed. Game theory models can be dual use. It is possible that a model can be used for cyber offense and cyber defense. Machine learning and cybersecurity. Machine learning algorithms will help businesses to detect malicious activity faster and stop attack before they get started. Machine learning is already going mainstream on mobile devices, but thus far most of this activity has been for driving improved voice-based experiences on the likes of Google Now, Apple Siri, and Amazon's Alexa. However, machine learning can be used to analyze mobile endpoints as well. At the heart of machine learning is cybersecurity. There is a belief that it helps human analysts with all aspects of the job, including detecting malicious attack, analyzing the network, endpoint protection, and vulnerability assessment. There is possibly more excitement through around threat intelligence as well. So the real benefit of machine learning is that it could automate repetitive tasks, enabling staff to focus on more important work. Using machine learning to close zero-day vulnerabilities, particularly zero-day threats and others that target largely unsecured IoT devices. Cybersecurity challenges, attacks. An AI system collects input from which model features are extracted and used within the models. It then interprets the meaning of the output and takes appropriate action. The attack surface in this case can be defined with respect to the data processing pipeline. An adversary can attempt to manipulate either the collection or the processing of data to corrupt the target model, thus tampering the original output. The main attack scenarios identified, we have the evasion attack. This is the most common type of attack in the adversary setting. The adversary tries to evade the system by adjusting malicious samples during testing phase. This setting does not assume any influence over the training data. Poisoning attack, this type of attack known as contamination of the training data takes place during the training time of the machine learning model. So an adversary tries to poison the training data by increasing and injecting carefully designed samples to compromise the whole learning process eventually. Exploratory attack, these attacks do not influence training dataset. Given black box access to the model, they try to gain as much knowledge as possible about the learning algorithm of the underlying system and pattern in training data. Cybersecurity use cases. Applying machine learning and analytics to information security is a step forward in defending against advanced real-time and real-world attacks and threats. A few use cases include network traffic profiling, spam filtering, malware detection, network anomaly detection, insider threat detection, user behavior analytics, and malware family identification. An example here, we have Deep Exploit. Many greatly publicly available tools appeared lately that use machine learning capabilities to leverage penetration testing to another level. One of these tools is Deep Exploit. It was presented at Black Hat Conference in 2018. It is a fully automated penetration testing tool linked to Metasploit. So this great tool uses reinforcement learning or self-learning. It uses the A3C machine learning and Metasploit. ATC stands for Asynchronous Advantage Actor Critic. So, where asynchronous means multiprocessing, the actor critic model is basically deep convolutional Q-learning model where agent implements Q-learning, and the advantage is the value that tells us if there is an improvement in a certain action compared to the expected average value of that state based on. So this is a high-level overview of Deep Exploit architecture. The A3C executes the exploit to the target service via the RPC API. So the A3C is developed by Keras and TensorFlow. It is used to execute and exploit to the target service based on instruction from the A3C. So Deep Exploit identifies the status of all opened ports on the target server and execute the exploit. So using Deep Exploit, pen tester can greatly improve testing cost efficiency, and for information security officer, they can quickly identify vulnerabilities of owned servers. Machine learning-based SIG analysis. One of the main techniques in steganography is hiding messages in images by altering the LSB of the pixel. So the LSB is the least significant bit. So they alter the LSB of the pixel with those of the message bits. The result is an image with a message hidden in it that the human eye cannot distinguish from the original image. So an ML model can be trained and test the presence of LSB steganography. CAPTCHA breaker. A CAPTCHA is a system intended to prevent automated access or scrapping. It does so by asking questions that are mean to recognize when the user is a human and when the user is a program. CAPTCHA breaker processes a CAPTCHA dataset to make it amenable to training a machine learning model. Social Mapper. Social Mapper is an OSINT tool that allows you to correlate the multitude of social media profiles of a target using facial recognition. The largest benefit of Social Mapper is that by combining name search with image recognition, as opposed to just the name search, it can eliminate false positives, saving the social engineer valuable time. AI can be part of attacks as well. Attacker could use AI or machine learning to protect their infrastructure, to detect intruder, to detect inactive or suspicious nodes in their network. They can use ML to generate and distribute new content, such as phishing emails, spam, choose the best target. They can misuse the AI model from a defender solution as a black box. The attacker can install victim's protective solution on their device using the same configuration and use it to identify what traffic or content will pass through the defenses. AI in malware. So a malware developer could use AI as well to generate hard-to-detect malware variants, conceal their malware in their victim's network, to let other nodes in the botnet learn collectively and identify the most effective attacks form. AI can be part of targeted attacks. Can be part of attacks in mobile environment. So machine learning algorithm can identify the popular mobile apps and blend in. Unaware user might download such apps to their mobile device and thus infect them with malware. IoT devices such as router, security cameras, and various controllers are growing in numbers. Many companies which implement them underestimate the fact that these devices are small computers prone to vulnerabilities and exploitation. Attackers targeting IoT devices could use AI to generate credentials and use them to infiltrate other similar IoT devices. Find the new vulnerabilities of the IoT devices as well. So if the IoT devices are part of a botnet, algorithm can be used to distribute across all the nodes for collective learning. An example here, we have DeepLocker, the next generation AI-powered malware. So what is unique about DeepLocker is that the use of AI makes the trigger conditions to unlock the attack almost impossible to reverse engineer. The malicious payload will only be unlocked if the intended target is reached. It achieves this by using a deep neural network AI model. So DeepLocker is also capable of switching the concealed trigger condition into a key or a password, which will then be required to unlock and drop the malicious payload. IBM researchers created a proof of concept in which they masked the Maracai ransomware in a video conference application to ensure that malware detection tools are unable to spot it. The researchers then trained the AI model to identify the face of a specific individual to unlock the ransomware and execute it on targeted systems. Imagine that this video conferencing application is distributed and downloaded by millions of people, which is a plausible scenario nowadays, on many public platforms. So when launched, the app would feed camera snapshots into the embedded AI model, but otherwise behave normally for all users except the intended target. In essence, the proof of concept also showcases that when a victim is in front of the targeted system, the malware video conferencing app would use the camera to identify the victim's face. The facial features are already programmed to function as the key to unlock the ransomware. In other words, the victim's face would work as a trigger to activate the ransomware and deliver the malicious payload. So while a class of malware like DeepLocker has not been seen in the wild today, these AI tools are publicly available, as are the malware techniques being employed. So it's only a matter of time before we start seeing these tools combined by adversary actors and cyber criminals. In fact, we would not be surprised if this type of attacks were already being deployed. Malgun, creating evasive malware. So a novel algorithm named Malgun was proposed to generate adversary example from a machine learning based black box malware detector. A neural network based substitute detector is used to fit the detector. Once the detector is updated, malware authors can crack it. So this process making machine learning based malware detection algorithm unable to work. So we implement Malgun to attack several robust models and evaluate the performance of those models. Remember the GAN methodology? The GAN attacker has a generator and a substitute detector, which is a discriminator. So the generator takes a malware feature vector M and a noise vector as input and generates an adversary example based on that malware sample. So the substitute detector is used to fit the behavior of the black box classifier and feed the gradient information back to the generator. Deepwning. Deepwning is a framework for evaluating the robustness of machine learning tools against adversary attacks. It has become widely known in the data science community. As a consequence, for each model, it is important to not only report the usual performance metrics such as accuracy, precision, and recall, but also to have some measure of the adversary robustness of the model. The deepwning framework is a simple toolkit for doing so. This framework is built on top of TensorFlow. All the included example and code implements deep neural network, but they can be used to generate adversary images for similarities, task classifier that are not implemented with DNN. So this is because of the phenomenon of transferability in machine learning. This means that adversary sample crafted with a DNN model A may be able to fool another structure, DNN model B, as well as some other support vector machine model C, for example. Now that we have defined artificial intelligence, machine learning, and deep learning, and their area of applications, looked at AI technique, AI threats, and AI in cybersecurity, we'll turn to proof of concepts. So the steps needed to create and run machine learning algorithm include data exploration, data pre-processing, then splitting data for training and testing, preparing the model, assembling all the steps, and we train the model, and lastly, we run the prediction and evaluation. The first POC, the phishing detection. So there are many social engineering techniques used by criminals. Phishing, this is the most often used technique. It happens when an attacker, concealed as a trusted entity, targets a victim into opening an email, instant message, or text message. In this first POC, we will cover phishing detection using machine learning. For our model, we are going to use the UCI machine learning repositories that contain phishing website dataset. So the dataset is provided as an ARF file. In the Python environment, we load the required libraries, the logistic regression classifier, we train the classifier and make predictions. The accuracy of our model is approximately 85%. This is a good accuracy since our model detected 85 phishing URLs out of 100. To build the second model, we are going to import the decision tree classifier. The accuracy of the second model is approximately 91%, which is a great result compared to the first model. The second POC, Android malware detection. So analyzing malware with the API calls plays a huge role in malware analysis. Thus, APIs can give malware analysts an idea about malware behavior, especially when basic static analysis wasn't successful due to obfuscation techniques like packers and cryptors. Malware analysts can gain an understanding of how a malicious file works by studying API calls. As a demonstration, we built an Android malware detection project using a support vector machine learning algorithm fed by API calls dataset. So before building the model, we need to import some useful modules, then do the pre-processing to identify the data and the labels. We need to extract the most important features, because computing all of the available features would be a heavy task. To train the model, we are going to use the support vector machine classifier. The accuracy of this model is 98%, which is a great detection rate. To conclude, AI made enormous advances over the past 70 years. The use of AI can bring with it transformative improvements in various economic and social sectors. However, as we have seen, there are also some important threats stemming from this technology. The goal is to balance the power of this technology and to align our personal and collective goals with advancement in AI. The references of this presentation can be found here. And that's all for today. We still have some time for your questions.